Heidi Rader. I'm with Cooperative Extension and Tanana Chiefs Conference. I'm here in the Alaska Garden at the Georgeson Botanical Garden at the University of Alaska Fairbanks. And today I'm going to talk about what grows in Alaska, depending on where you live. So Alaska is a big state. We're the biggest state in the U.S., about twice as big as Texas. And we've got a lot of different growing regions here in Alaska. You're probably familiar with the USDA Plant Hardiness Zone map. That's a good starting point, but all of that determines is just your average minimum temperature. So it's particularly useful for perennials. You know, will they survive the winter? But it doesn't tell you a lot about your actual growing season. So things you want to think about with your actual growing season is how much precipitation do you get? Is it very windy? What are your average temperatures in the summer? Do they get pretty hot or are they pretty mild? Also, the length of your growing season is really important. You know, when is your last frost in the spring? When is your first frost in the fall? And do you get any mid-season frosts? Also, what about your day length? Do you get 24-hour sunlight like here in interior or in northern Alaska, or are they a little bit shorter down in southeast Alaska? So here in interior Alaska where we are, you know, we get very hot days. Right now it's about up in the mid-80s and it has been for the last week. We don't generally get a lot of rain, but sometimes we have rainy summers. We have pretty harsh winters. And generally not a lot of wind. But if you're in southeast Alaska, you're gonna get a lot more rain, a lot more wind. The temperatures are not gonna get quite as hot during the day. The days are not as long, but your winters are more mild and your growing seasons are longer as well. So that means you can grow more perennials and more berries and possibly more fruit varieties as well. You know, northwest Alaska, you've got some of the coastal conditions as well as colder temperatures. So you have quite a few challenges. Up further north in the Arctic, you're probably gonna have to grow most things in a high tunnel to be successful because you might get mid-season frosts and the growing season is so short. And of course, you're gonna have very long days. So when you're deciding what to grow in Alaska, first think about your growing conditions of your region. You also want to think about microclimate. So even within a given community, you might have a lot of variation in your growing conditions. So here in Fairbanks, for example, up in the hills, it gets quite a bit warmer and stays warmer in the winter. While in the valleys, you might even get some mid-season frosts, and it tends to be quite a bit colder in the winter. You could even have some microclimates on your own garden or farm. So you could have an area that's a little bit shadier, a little bit wetter, or a sunny area, or a drier area. You could also have variations in soils and your soil conditions. Another microclimate might be right next to your house and a foundation planting. So I planted tulips right next to my house last year and they did quite well. But when I planted them in a bed further from my house, they didn't survive because it gets quite a bit colder there. So that's an example of a microclimate. And so in general, in addition to thinking about the growing conditions of your region, you also want to think about various types of crops. So in theory, you can grow anything anywhere, say in a greenhouse, or if you provide enough heat, you could grow things like bananas or coffee in a greenhouse if you heated it all year and provided light. But that takes a lot of energy. And so we want to grow things that are easy to grow. So here in Alaska, cold season crops are going to be the easiest thing to grow and the things that you don't have to add a lot of heat to or provide much season extension for. So cold season crops are things in the broccoli family, like broccoli, kohlrabi, cabbage, collards, peas, carrots. Those are all cold season crops, potatoes. And then within cold season crops, you can divide them up into frost hardy and semi-frost hardy. So again, the broccoli family, things in that family will be frost hardy, while things like beets or lettuce or potatoes, they're semi-frost hardy. And that means if you get a light frost, you're gonna see some damage on the plants. But things like kale, they'll actually survive with a pretty hard frost and even with a little bit of snow. So you can continue harvesting in the winter a little bit, into the late fall and winter a little bit with some things like that. Worm season crops, on the other hand, like squash or snap beans. Here we've got squash here. That's an example of a worm season crop. And we've got a lot of different kinds of squash here. They are definitely a warm season crop, so they're going to benefit if you give them a good start ahead of the season and start them inside, and then use plastic mulch or a high tunnel. They will definitely benefit from that. They like temperatures between about 70 degrees and 95 degrees, while cold season crops like temperatures between 70 and 75 degrees. They're not going to do much above 80 degrees. And in some cases, that can actually cause them to bolt or to go to seed. And so with your warm season crops, they're not frost hardy at all. And so if you see a frost in the weather forecast, cover them with frost cloth if you can, or harvest what you can, because even a light frost can just devastate your warm season crops. And so another thing to consider with when you're choosing what to grow, you've got perennials, which have a longer life cycle than 1 year, while an annual has a life cycle of 1 year. So a lot of perennials, of course, need to grow year after year to produce. That's not always the case, but in a lot of cases, they grow year after year, and so they need to be able to survive the winter temperatures. So definitely consult your USDA plant hardiness zone for perennials. For annuals, what you can do is look at the days to maturity. So things like corn, for instance, some varieties of corn will not reach maturity in our short growing season. But you can always start things inside to give them a head start and possibly help them reach maturity. But it still may depend on having a warmer than normal summer. So that's a little bit about how to choose what to grow here in Alaska, depending on where you live. I'm Heidi Rader here with Cooperative Extension Service. In another video, I'm going to be talking about how to choose which varieties to grow here in Alaska.